Hi, I'm Sumit Kulal, and I'm going to give a brief overview of our paper titled Programmatic Concept Learning for Human Motion Description and Synthesis. This is joint work with Jiayuan Ma, Alex Aiken, and Jiajun Wu. Recent progress in computer vision and deep learning has pushed the boundaries for several video analysis tasks. There have been major advances in human video description, such as recognizing and localizing actions, and human motion and video synthesis, such as control generation from descriptions. However, current systems that perform video description and synthesis focus solely on their respective tasks. Moreover, learning these recognition and synthesis models requires lots of paired data. We posit that these are better learned jointly and present a framework that enables this learning in a data-efficient manner. In this work, we present programmatic motion concepts, a novel hierarchical representation for human motion. PMC presents a unified framework for human motion description, synthesis, and editing. We can learn the PMC representation in a data-efficient manner by leveraging the inductive biases present in human motion data. We present a brief overview of our representation and learning framework. Beginning with low-level inputs such as a sequence of frames or key points, PMC learns a distribution of high-level motion concepts such as jumping jacks. Building on prior work, we first represent input motion as a sequence of motion primitives. We further represent motion concepts as a grouping of consecutive motion primitives that have a semantic name, such as jumping jacks or squats. We start by describing our motion primitive synthesis pipeline. We build upon prior work in primitive-based motion representations. The key idea is representing motion trajectories as a sequence of curves, each of which can be described with only a few parameters. Motion programs consider three kinds of primitives: stationary, linear, and circular. Shown here are two such examples. In this work, we expand the expressiveness of primitives by also introducing spline-based primitives. After obtaining the sequence of motion primitives, we learn to group these primitives into motion concepts. Shown here is our model that learns to align input primitives with video-level labels. We feed in the primitives to a simple neural architecture to compute the concept label predictions. We then train it using a CTC objective that learns to align the concept predictions with the video level labels. Once we have successfully trained the description model, we can infer the PMC representations from input videos. We then learn the reverse process of going from concept labels to key point sequences. We use the alignments predicted by our description model to extract individual instances of each concept class. We then learn a simple probabilistic generative model for the concept class, which when sampled yields novel instances. Finally, after model fitting, we can perform controlled motion synthesis by sampling these models in sequence. We present a few applications of PMC. We evaluated PMC on three downstream applications: video description, controlled motion synthesis, and interactive video manipulation. Let's begin with video description. Here, the task is to accurately recognize and localize concept instances in an input video. A visualization of the localized intervals for a sample is shown here. Different colors denote different intervals located by the models. The localized intervals from our model closely aligns with the ground truth. Next, we evaluate controlled motion synthesis. We generate realistic motion and video sequences by prompting a description. Here are some qualitative results. The input prompt is 63 repetitions of jumping jacks. We observe that both the baseline models produce unnatural motion. On the right is our synthesized video for the prompted description, which looks more realistic and representative of the input description. Finally, we show some interactive video editing demonstrations. On the left, we have an input video and the corresponding detected poses. Using PMC, we can identify that there are two concepts, that is, two repetitions of jumping jacks, each with two primitives, that is moving hands up and bringing them down. The shown edits have been applied, resulting in the following output. Here we perform both low-level edits, such as slowing down the descent of every repetition, and high-level edits, such as adding an extra repetition of jumping jacks, and two repetitions of a different concept, high knees. In conclusion, we introduce programmatic motion concepts, a novel hierarchical representation for human motion. PMC presents a unified framework for human motion description, synthesis, and editing. We show that our concept representation can be learned in a data-efficient manner and is effective on multiple downstream applications. Thank you.